Okay, good morning students. Today we have lecture number 3 on fluid mechanics, lecture number 3, and now we shall study Archimedes' principle. In the previous class we have studied about the Pascal's law, so today Archimedes' principle. A great Greek philosopher, Greek scientist Archimedes has discovered a law accidentally related to fluids that we all have to study. Okay. According to Archimedes, that is according to this Archimedes principle, or Archimedes discovered that when a body is immersed completely or partially in a liquid, when a body is immersed completely or partially in a fluid, the body will experience as an upthrust. The body will experience as an upthrust. When a body is immersed completely or partially in a fluid, the body will experience as an upthrust, which is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. When a body is immersed completely or partially in a fluid, the body will experience as an upward force. Upthrust means upward force, and this upward force will be equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. So this is called Archimedes' principle. So according to Archimedes' principle, when a body is immersed completely or partially in a liquid, the body will experience as an upward force. This upward force is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. Got the idea? Okay, so now let us consider a body. Okay, let us consider a container. In this container there is a liquid. So let us consider a body. A body is there. Density of the material of this body. Okay, a body is there. So let us consider a body having a density sigma. The density of the material of the body is sigma. And immersed in a liquid, immersed in a liquid of density rho. Rho is the density of the liquid, sigma is the density of the body. Consider a body immersed in a liquid of density rho. And now the body will experience the pressure, that is force, buoyant force, that is when an object is immersed in a fluid, the fluid will exert a normal force that we have known, normal thrust on this surface of the body. So now, the normal force acting on the vertical surfaces of this body, the normal forces acting on the vertical surfaces of the body will be cancelled out. The normal force acting on the vertical surfaces, these two vertical surfaces, the normal force exerted by the liquid on the vertical surfaces of the body will cancel out because they are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. And now, the liquid will exert a force on the upper surface of the body. The liquid will exert a force on the upper surface of the body. So, the force exerted by liquid on a upper face of body is F1, F1 is equal to pressure exerted into area, that is pressure exerted by the liquid on this surface into area. Let this surface is at a height or at a depth of H1. Let this surface is at a depth of H1. Then pressure exerted is given by, that is P1 is equal to P0 plus rho GH1 into A. Because we know that is P is equal to P0 plus rho GH. This formula we know. Rho is the density of the liquid, G is acceleration due to gravity, and height is the depth of the point. So P1, that is pressure exerted by the liquid on this face, So it is P1 is equal to P0 plus rho g H1, and A is the cross sectional area of the body or cross sectional area of the object. And now similarly, the force exerted by the liquid, this force will be acting in a downward direction. This force will be acting in a downward direction. Downward direction. Actually, it will be perpendicular to the surface. Perpendicular to the surface, so it is downward direction. And now similarly, force exerted by liquid, liquid on lower face of body, on lower face of body is F2, and it is given by, and it is given by, so that is F2 is equal to, F2 is equal to P2 into A. What is P2? That is, P2 is nothing but the pressure exerted by the liquid. Pressure exerted by the liquid at the lower face of the body. Pressure exerted by the liquid at the lower face of the body. And P2 can be done as, so it is P0 plus rho g H2 into A. Rho g H2 into A. And this pressure or this force is in the upward direction. So it is in the upward direction. Whereas this force was in the downward direction. And let this height as H2, this height as H2 from top of the liquid to lower face, the height as H2, and this height is H1, so we are used to H1. Okay. So now, since H2 is greater than H1, so therefore F2 will be greater than F1. That is, force exerted at the lower face of the body, force exerted by the liquid at the lower face of the body will be more compared to force exerted by the liquid at the upper face of the body. Hence, the net force, hence the total or the net force acting on the body will be in the upward direction, and that is called as the upthrust. The net force acting on the body, that is called as the upthrust. The net force on the body, that is upthrust, is F is equal to F2 minus F1. That is, F is equal to F2. F2 means here it we have, that is P0 plus rho g H2 into A minus F1. F1 is here. So it is P0 plus rho g H1 into A. This is minus. So now open the bracket and simplify this. Open the bracket and simplify. So on opening the bracket, P0, this is plus P0 into A, and this is minus P0 into A, and P0 A, P0 A cancel. So this rho and g are common. So rho and g are taken common, and you will get H2 minus H1 into A. So this will be the force, that is net force, upthrust. Now let L be the length of the body. Let L be the length of body or height of the body, that is length of the body. So this much height or this much length of the body as L. L be the length of body. So then you can write F is equal to rho g into, that is H2 minus H1. H2 minus H1, that can be done as L into A. So now L into A. Now F is equal to, that is rho into g into L into A, that is length into cross sectional area, that is nothing but volume of the body. And rho into V, rho is the density of the liquid, V is the volume of the body. And now the volume of body volume of body will be equal to volume of liquid displaced. Volume of liquid displaced. Volume of body will be equal to volume of liquid displaced, because complete volume of the body is inside the liquid. See here, the body I have taken while doing this one is the completely body was immersed inside the liquid. So therefore, the volume of body will be equal to the volume of liquid displaced. Volume of body completely immersed will be equal to the volume of liquid displaced. So therefore, we can write F is equal to rho g into volume of liquid displaced. I'll write it as VL. This is volume of liquid and this is density of the liquid. Density of the liquid into volume. Density into volume, you can write it as mass of the liquid. Mass of the liquid displaced into g. And mass of the liquid displaced into g, that is nothing but weight of the liquid displaced. So this is the weight of liquid displaced. Weight of liquid displaced. So this is called Archimedes principle. Weight of liquid displaced. And F is called upthrust, or it is also called as buoyant force. F is nothing but upthrust, or it is also called as buoyant force. So some of the books they will write it as FB. FB means buoyant force acting on this body in the upward direction. Understood? So that will be equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. So this is called Archimedes principle. Once again I will tell Archimedes principle. According to Archimedes principle, when a body is partially or completely immersed in a liquid, when a body is partially or completely immersed in a liquid, the body will experience an upthrust. The body will experience an upthrust equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. Upthrust, that upthrust is nothing but buoyant force, and buoyant force will be equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. Understood? So this is called Archimedes principle. Understood? Okay, so now we shall study apparent weight, that is apparent, one more concept. So just for our understanding, so now as a result of this buoyant force, the buoyant force is acting in the upward direction, whereas the true weight of the body was in the downward direction. As a result of that, the body will appear to be lighter inside the water. Have you observed when a water is taken in a container, and that container is inside a big water container. So for example, so it is a water bottle, and a water bottle, consider steel bottle, it may consider steel bottle completely filled with water, and it is kept inside the water, another water container, then that bottle appears to be lighter. Yes or no? The bottle appears to be lighter because there will be an upward force acting on that object, so that is buoyant force. So due to that buoyant force, the body will appears to be lighter. It is not lighter, appears to be lighter. And that weight is called as apparent weight of the body. So apparent weight of the body, that is weight of the body when it is immersed in a liquid, is equal to the apparent weight of the body is equal to the true weight of body minus upthrust. True weight of body minus upthrust. This is the formula we have to remember. That is the apparent weight of a body, that is weight of a body when it is immersed inside the liquid. Weight of the body when it is immersed inside the liquid, that is that is called apparent weight of the body. And true weight is nothing but weight of the body when it is in the air medium. You can say true weight or actual weight is nothing but weight of the body when it is in the air medium, and this is upthrust. So that is minus upthrust. So now minus, this is minus. So now the apparent weight of the body I will write it as W dash, and true weight of the body W minus upthrust. Upthrust is nothing but buoyant force, that is FB. Okay. So W dash, that is apparent weight, is equal to true weight of the body can be done as MG. True weight of the body can be done as MG, or you can write it as volume of the body into density of the body. Volume of the body into density of the body into acceleration due to gravity. Density of the body we have taken it as sigma, and density of the liquid is rho. Remember that. Weight of the body we am writing, weight of the body is volume of the body into density of the body into acceleration due to gravity. And buoyant force, buoyant force is given by, it is, I will write this as rho or VL into rho into g. And VL is volume of the liquid displaced. And volume of the liquid displaced will be same as the volume of the body if the body is completely immersed. Volume of the liquid displaced will be same as the volume of the body if the body is completely immersed. So now you can take is taken common. So it is W dash is equal to, so that is you can take common. So V and G is taken common. You can write it as 1 minus rho divided by sigma. 1 minus rho divided by sigma. So if both are equal, that is V is equal to VL. It is volume of the body is equal to the volume of the liquid displaced. Then W dash is equal to Vg into 1 minus rho divided by sigma. Rho is the density of the liquid and sigma is the density of the body. So this is called apparent weight of the body. Understood? So just for our understanding, because sometimes they will ask in the numericals or CET. So that's why I am explaining about apparent weight of the body. Understood? So this is all about Archimedes principle. Archimedes principle, they will not ask much more on this. So, but still you have to know, that's why I explained all this Archimedes principle. Okay, so now on the basis of this Archimedes principle, let us study the next concept. The next concept depends upon this Archimedes principle. So it is law of flotation. So now let us study about the flotation. Flotation. Flotation, when does a body will float, that kind of things. So, or when does a body will sink. Okay. So now, when a body is immersed in a liquid, let us say the density of the body is sigma and density of the liquid is rho. Density of the body is sigma and density of the liquid is rho. When a body is immersed in a liquid, completely or partially, the different forces acting on the body, two different forces will act on the body. First one is weight of body, that is given by, so mass of the body into acceleration due to gravity. Mass of the body can be written as volume of the body into density. Mass is equal to volume into density. Mass is equal to density into volume. So volume into density into acceleration due to gravity. So where sigma is the density of the body, V is the volume of the body. So this gives the weight of the body, and this weight of the body will be acting downward. The weight of the body will be acting in the downward direction, right? Downward direction. And the force, that is upthrust, the buoyant force acting on the body, that is buoyant force or upward force acting on the body, that is volume of the liquid displaced is same as volume of the body, if you take. So volume of the liquid displaced into density of the liquid, that is upthrust, that is nothing but the upward force is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. Upward force or upthrust is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced, and weight of the liquid displaced can be written as mass of the liquid displaced into acceleration due to gravity. Mass of the liquid displaced into acceleration due to gravity, and mass of the liquid is volume of the liquid displaced into density of the liquid. Volume of the liquid displaced into density of the liquid into acceleration due to gravity. And this force will be acting in the upward direction. So it will be acting in the upward direction. I will write it as FB. Okay, no problem. FB I will write. That is buoyant force. So now case number one. There are two forces acting on a body when the body is immersed in a liquid. One of the force is weight of the body. Weight of the body acting vertically downward. And another one is upward force, that is buoyant force, that is weight of the liquid displaced by the body, that is acting in the upward direction. So now, when density of the body is greater than density of the liquid, when density of the body is greater than the density of the liquid, then what happens? Then the weight of the body will be greater than the weight of the body will be greater than the buoyant force. Weight of the body will be greater than the buoyant force. As a result, the body will move downward. As a result, the body will move downward and the body will sink. The body will sink. The body will sink or the body will move downward. So when does a body will sink? A body will sink if the density of the material of the body is greater than the density of the body is greater than the density of the liquid. When the density of the body is greater than the density of the liquid, then weight of the body will be greater than the buoyant force. Weight of the body will be greater than the buoyant force or upward force or weight of the liquid displaced. So then the body will sink. This is case number one. So case number two, when density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid. When density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid. So in this case, the body will sink. The body will sink means it will move to the bottom of the container. Okay. When density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid, then weight of the body will be equal to the buoyant force. Weight of the body will be equal to the buoyant force. Under this condition, the body will be floats. The body will floats under neutral equilibrium. That is such that the upper face of the body is just at the upper surface of the liquid, like this. So when a density of the body is equal to the density of the liquid, that is weight of the body is equal to the buoyant force, then the entire volume of the body will be inside the liquid, such that the upper face of the body is just at the surface of the liquid. The upper face of the body is just equal to the surface of the liquid. So this is called floating. The body is floating under neutral equilibrium, or you can say the body is in a neutral equilibrium. The body is in neutral equilibrium. Now case number three. So when density of the body is less than the density of the liquid. When density of the body is less than the density of the liquid, then what happens? Then the weight of the body is less than the buoyant force. That means buoyant force is more, that is upward force is more compared to the weight of the body. Then the body moves upwards. Then the body moves upwards and it starts floating and it floats with some part of the body above the liquid level. That is, the body will start to float like this. So this is body. So the body will be like this. So that is, so this is when a weight of, when a density of the body is less than the density of the liquid. When density of the body is less than the density of the liquid, then weight of the body will be less and upward force, that is buoyant force, will be more. As a result, the body will move upward. The body will move upward and the body will floats. The body will floats such that only a small part of the body will be inside the liquid. Only a small part of the body will be inside the liquid. The body will floats. So this is also called floats. So here also the body is floating and here also the body is said to be floating. So under these two conditions, the body is said to be floating. So here the body will floats such that, so you can write a formula, such that the weight of the body is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. The weight of the body is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. And weight of the liquid displaced can be written as volume of the liquid displaced into density of the liquid into acceleration due to gravity. And now the weight of the body can be written as volume of the body into density of the body into acceleration due to gravity is equal to VL. That is, you can write V in also, V in into rho into G. Where V in is nothing but the volume of the body inside the liquid. V in is nothing but the volume of the body inside the liquid. And volume of the body inside the liquid will be same as the volume of the liquid displaced. The volume of the body inside the liquid will be same as the volume of the liquid displaced. Understood? And V is the total volume of the body. And sigma is the density of the body. And rho is the density of the liquid. So this is called flotation. This is the condition of flotation. So a body is said to be floating. So when it satisfies this equation. A body is said to be floating when it satisfies this equation mathematically. So a body is floats when density of the body is less or equal. When density of the body is or in general, a body is said to be floating when the density of the body is less or equal to the density of the liquid. So we can make a law. We can make a law of flotation. A body is said to be floating. A body is said to be floating in a liquid when the density of the body is less than or equal to the density of the liquid. When the density of the body is less than or equal to the density of the liquid, then the body is said to be floats. The body is said to floats in a liquid or in a fluid. So this is called flotation. Understood? So here the body will sinks. Here the body is floating. So this is also called neutral equilibrium. Floating with upper surface of the body is just at the top surface of the liquid. And here the body floats with some part of the body above the liquid level. So only a small part of the body, only a few volume of the body is inside the liquid. So that is V in. Understood? Hope you understood all these concepts. These concepts are actually for this flotation is there for theory exam. This flotation is there for theory exam. That Archimedes principle and all these things, mathematics I have written, all these things for the CET exam purpose or numerical purpose. Understood? Okay. So understand this concept, it will be better for you people to solve some other numericals related to this. Okay. So this is called flotation. Okay. Or you can also give a law for flotation. Just now I told a different law also. You can say like this. A body is said to be floating. A body is said to be floating if the weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of the body. The weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of the body is equal to or greater than or is equal to or greater than the weight of the body. So like this also you can tell. You can also tell the definition in a different manner. Okay. So this is called the law of flotation. So next, so these all the things we have to study in the topic called fluid statics. So far what we have studied is fluid statics. This Pascal's law, Archimedes principle, this flotation, all these things comes under the fluid statics. Fluid statics. Okay. So one more thing, so I will, one more thing is there, small thing which I have to tell in the previous class only, just left over. So I will tell open tube manometer. Open tube manometer. Okay. So a open tube manometer is a simple device. A open tube manometer is a simple device used to measure the pressure of a gas contained in a vessel. A open tube manometer is a simple device used to measure the pressure of the gas in a vessel. Okay. A open tube manometer is a simple device. It is used to measure the pressure of a gas contained in a vessel. And a open tube manometer consists of a U-shaped tube. A open tube manometer consists of a U-shaped tube and some kind of liquid. Some liquid is present in this U-shaped tube. So, open tube manometer is a simple device used to measure the pressure of a gas. Pressure of a gas inside a vessel. Pressure of a gas inside a vessel. This is a vessel consisting of gas. So what is the pressure of this gas? That can be measured by using this U-shaped tube. Understood? So now, a open tube manometer consists of a U-shaped glass tube. U-shaped glass tube whose one end is open to the atmosphere, and another end is connected to the vessel consisting of gas. So now, the pressure exerted by the gas will be the pressure on this liquid. The liquid will be there already in the U-tube. So as a result, the liquid level inside this U-tube will rise. If the pressure exerted by the gas is more, the liquid level inside the tube will rise. If the pressure exerted by the gas is less, the liquid level will decrease. By measuring the liquid level, so say this as point A, okay. So the similarly, so at the same level, say this point as B. So this height of the liquid as H. So by measuring the height of the liquid, we can measure the pressure exerted by the gas. The pressure exerted by the gas is equal to the pressure at the point A. The pressure exerted by the gas is equal to the pressure at the point A, and pressure at the point A is same as the pressure at the point B, because A and B are at the same level. Inside the U-shaped tube. So hence, pressure at the point A is same as pressure at the point B, and pressure at the point B can be written as, so pressure due to this liquid plus atmospheric pressure, that is atmospheric pressure P naught, and density of the liquid is rho G H. So this gives the pressure exerted by the gas. So pressure exerted by the gas in a vessel is given by P is equal to P naught plus rho G H. So by measuring this height, we can measure the pressure exerted by the gas contained in the vessel. So this is called open tube manometer. It is very simple. So very simple, just for your understanding, I am telling. Okay. So this is not for theory exam actually. It's for CET. Such kind of numericals will be there. So that's why I explained this one. Understood? The gas will exert a pressure on this liquid. This is a liquid. It may be a mercury, or it may be a water, or it may be another liquid will be there inside the U-shaped tube. So now, as the pressure exerted will be more, the height of the liquid will rise. If the pressure exerted by the gas is less, the height of the liquid will decrease. So by measuring the height of the liquid, we can measure the pressure exerted by the gas. So pressure exerted by the gas, P is nothing but pressure exerted by the gas is equal to P naught. P naught is atmospheric pressure plus rho, density of this liquid, into G, H. H is height of the liquid in this arm. Understood? So this is called open tube manometer. Okay. So this is fluid statics. This much is enough for fluid statics. Next we have to study about the fluid dynamics. That means, so far what we have studied during all that things, the fluid was at rest. That is liquid. Liquid or gases, whatever we have considered, that was at rest. Now, when the fluid is in motion, when the fluid, that is liquid or gases, is in motion, so then what about the pressure, then what about all the different things, then we have to study. It is called fluid dynamics. That we continue in the next class. Fluid dynamics we shall continue in the next class. Understood? Okay.